think stylistically they're very much alike. And as it is with a lot of Baroque pieces of music for chorus, it ends with a fugue. And if you don't know what a fugue is, I shall not tell you. Any of you don't want to know. And if you were to pick up one of those handles in front of you, you don't have to, but if you were to do it and look in almost any page, you would see music that is written in chordal style, where all of the voices move along at the same time. And that's your basic format for chordal singing throughout the century. Well, when the Baroque came along, came some more interesting kinds of things composers wanted to do. And that meant not just having the chorus move step by step, lockstep, using the same words at the same time, but they wanted to give each section an individual line to sing for itself. And then another voice would come in, and then another voice would come in, and then another voice would come in. So the old style was called homophony, one sound, one voice. This is called polyphony. And it's the very essence of all the great stuff for me about choral music. So the first thing you're going to hear me do is ask the choir to demonstrate a short piece of the last movement of the Vivaldi you're about to hear, because it is a fugue. And I want to see if you can tell, if you can hear the voices weaving in and out. So listen carefully to this little bit of polyphony.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. following the interlude, I have a surprise for you.
Thank you.
French and the Germans were fighting each other, and then on Christmas Eve, one Frenchman stood up and started singing this beautiful Christmas carol. And to the surprise of everyone, the war stopped. The fighting stopped. The guns stopped firing. And the Germans, instead of firing back, they answered and replied with their own Christmas carol. And so for that evening, that special evening, both sides experienced peace. This is Saint Noel, O Holy Night.
Thank you.
gives you chills. So come back in the springtime and listen to that. But tonight, we're doing the seven joys of Christmas. We're doing six to the seven. And only because we didn't quite have time to learn the seventh one. But it's okay. It's all good. And the first movement of this is another example of polyphony. Kurt Meacham loves to layer voice after voice after voice. Different from Vivaldi, though, in many ways, but one of the ways it's different is he begins a line with X words, and then almost immediately, one syllable later, he'll do the same words again and again and again, until maybe he has five versions of those same words going on at the same time. And if it weren't so organized, it would sound sort of like a crowd talking, you know, like a cocktail party or something. But he is organized, to say the least. So before you even understand the words of the first movement, I think I want to read you the poem that he set this to. It's an old English poem, and I really love it. And I hope you will love this anyway, too. And I want to remind you that after this half of the concert, if you go through that back door there, there are all kinds of goodies and good times and tables where you can sit and chat and just be comrades, okay? So that's after the last piece. The poem ends, "This is the truth sent from above, the truth of God, the God of love. Therefore, don't turn me from your door, but hearken, both rich and poor. The first thing which I do relate is that God did man create. And we are heirs to endless woes till God the Lord did interpose. So a promise soon to come that he would redeem us by his Son. And at that season of the year, our blessed Redeemer did appear. And here he did live, and here he did preach, and many thousands he did teach. Thus he in love told us how to behave, to show us how we must be saved. And if you want to know the way, please to hear what he did say."
Still have the cell phone that was left in the ladies' restroom afterwards if you're unlikely to be used. Story about this. The choir is born with a story about this.